I'd like to welcome you all, those who are following us online. Greetings, special greetings to you today as we celebrate the coming down of the Holy Spirit and the founding of the church. And today, in a special way, we pray that the Spirit comes down to strengthen us during this time of COVID-19. And today, it's my pleasure to welcome Father Gilbert Banda, who will be our preacher today. Father Gilbert, thank you very much, and I introduce you to all those faithful for us online and those who are here. So we shall begin as one family, wherever we are, all over the world, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And for us as we celebrate this Paschal mystery, especially praying that the Spirit will strengthen us, we want to remember that we may be unworthy for the Spirit to come down upon us. So we recall our sins and ask for healing. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do.
May Almighty God have mercy on us all, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Shall we stand wherever we are and join in and praise the Lord?
And peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
To God in the highest, and peace to God's people.
Pray. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
First reading, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place, and suddenly a sound came from heaven, like the rush of a mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues as of fire, distributed and resting on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them the utterance. Now they were dwelling in Jerusalem, Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. And at this sound, the multitude came together and they were bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. And they were amazed and wondered, saying, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each one of us in his own native language, Parthians and Medes and Elamites and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabians. We hear them telling in our own tongues the mighty works of God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Our response is, Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, how great you are. How many are your works, O Lord? The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. You take away their breath, they die, returning to the dust from which they came. You send forth your spirit, and they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord last forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. May my thoughts be pleasing to him. I will rejoice in the Lord. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Second reading. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of service, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of working, but it is the same God who inspires them all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and all were made to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
As the Father has sent me, even so I sent you. Receive the Holy Spirit. On the evening of that day of the week, the doors being shut, where disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I sent you." And when he had said this, he breathed in them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain sins of any, they are retained." My dear sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord. There are two schools of thought in theology, maybe major schools of thought on this subject of the church. One school says the church was founded by Jesus when he instituted the Eucharist, that is on the Last Supper. And there is another school of thought which says the church was founded on this day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came into the upper room and the apostles and those who were there were empowered. And because they were empowered, they had no fear. They broke out of the room and they went far and wide, thereby spreading Christianity, spreading the gospel. I would like to say both schools are correct to some extent. With the Eucharist, it's the center of our faith. But also with Pentecost, without it, Christianity could have remained maybe a sect within Jerusalem. The Holy Spirit removed fear. And the Holy Spirit is very important in our life as Christians. Because without the Holy Spirit, we cannot be sent. Without the Holy Spirit, we cannot express our faith fearlessly. And looking at the disciples in the upper room, what were they doing there? They were praying. They were praying. And this is actually a period of 40 days since we began Easter. And they were behind closed doors, and they were full of fear. That's what they were doing. And being in that state, they couldn't go out because they were afraid of dying. And they had no energy. They were looking at their gloomy life, the Lord without them. But prayer gave them hope, and prayer enabled them to carry on believing that the Lord will come as he promised. And when the Holy Spirit came, fear was dispelled from their hearts. And they were ready even to die for the Lord. That's what the Holy Spirit does. The Holy Spirit removes fear. The Holy Spirit gives us the energy of God. And the Holy Spirit gives us a spirit of readiness whereby we are ready for anything. We are willing to die for the Lord. We come to the point of saying, "This is not my life, but this life belongs to God." That's what the Holy Spirit does. The Holy Spirit connects us to God. And as we are in the time of the lockdown, I believe most of us, we are in closed rooms. I believe that there is social distancing. And in that, there's a lot of fear. And the numbers rising, this is even compounding our fear. And we've been waiting for weeks. We started with 3 weeks, then 2 weeks, another 2 weeks. And there are extensions of this lockdown, and we don't know when we are going to end. That means a lot of fear, and probably now some of us are spiritually and emotionally strained. On this day, let us ask the Lord to breathe His Holy Spirit into us and renew us, and renew our hope, renew our vision of life, and renew our dreams. This is a time whereby if the Holy Spirit renews us, we find ourselves with more energy, either to remain in the lockdown so that this contagion dissipates, and we remain in the hope, knowing that our lives do not belong to us, but they belong to God. That is the plea, as the psalmist says, Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. And I can rephrase that by saying, Lord, pour out your spirit into our hearts and renew our strength and reinvigorate our dreams and empower us to live this life for you. And that's what we need. And remember, Jesus says, whatever you ask, you'll be given. And we ask, if we ask this in faith, we will be granted. And that is very important. And I'd just like to look at what the Spirit does. I've just given a brief enumeration about what the Spirit does. Probably I may start by asking a question, what is the Holy Spirit? Simply put, the Holy Spirit is God. We believe that God is Trinity, and the Holy Spirit is the one which enables. Actually, the Holy Spirit is the evidence that God is present here, because as we are united in this space and wherever you are, it is the Holy Spirit which is connecting us. And it is the Holy Spirit which makes our hearts beat as one, knowing that we are truly connected. That's what the Holy Spirit does. It is actually God uniting us and connecting us. And the other thing that the Holy Spirit does is that when it comes into your life, it dispels all negativity. It dispels anything that is not of God and actually puts the reign of God within your life. Because without God, without anything of God, we are negative. Without anything of God, we are always seeing life as perishing, life as dwindling, life as actually ebbing away from our hearts. That's what happens when we don't have the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit, actually, when we have that infill, it connects us to God in a way that we begin to see life the way God sees it. Without the Holy Spirit, we see the world in parts. When I look at you, I see a competitor. I see an enemy. I see a threat. And I'm in that defensive mode. And when you're in the defensive mode, you are not creative. But when I'm filled with the Holy Spirit, I begin to see a brother and a sister in you. And when I'm filled with this Holy Spirit, I see the connection of all life to the life of God. So in other words, we are spirit beings. And as spirit beings, we are all connected to the big spirit, which is the Spirit of God, or the Holy Spirit. And without this Holy Spirit, we die. Remember, Jesus in John chapter 15 says, I am the vine, and you are the branches. And if you are connected in me, if you abide in me, you have life. But any branch that is cut off from me withers away. So that's what we need today, to be reconnected to God so that we are filled with the life of God. Because I believe at this point, many of us, we are feeling dry. We are feeling distressed. We are full of fear. Probably, we have already given up. and we have no hope. And we can't pray. And usually when you don't have the Holy Spirit, you can't pray. Wherever you are, powerless as you are, ask the Holy Spirit to come into your heart. And then it fills you with the life of God. You find yourself with the strength. And the Holy Spirit, when you speak through it, you don't speak to the minds of people, but you speak to their hearts. You connect with other people in a way that ordinary human beings cannot do. Just like these disciples in the upper room, they were able to connect with people from all walks of life. The Holy Spirit will bring unity to our nation, and the Holy Spirit will bring hope and strength to our life. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
And let us now stand and together as one family profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father of all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made, for us men for our salvation, descended down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man, for our sins, by the name of Jesus Christ, he suffered death.
Dear God, our Father, we come to you today as we celebrate your coming down as the Holy Spirit. We pray that the Spirit can strengthen us and remove from us all the fear that we have. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Dear God, our Father, may the strength of your Spirit renew our dreams and our hope at this time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We continue to remember all those people suffering during this time, those people grieving, that the Spirit may comfort them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
With many prayers in our hearts, let us bring them to the Lord quietly in our hearts, wherever we are, at home and elsewhere. Dear God, our Father, these are the prayers we bring to you, and many other prayers deep down our hearts, prayers that you know already, but as your children, we still ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
now pray, my sisters and brothers, that this our sacrifice here may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mysteries of this sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. The same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us now proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the Blessed Mary, Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now stand, wherever we are around the world, at home, and pray in the words our Savior taught us as we say together, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Wherever we are, we strengthen each other with the spirit and show each other a sign of peace in safe ways. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to his banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter the banquet, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Soul of my Savior, sanctify my breast. Body of Christ, be thou my saving guest. Blood of my Savior, bathe me in thy tide. Wash me, ye waters, streaming from his side. Strength and protection, may his passion be. O blessed Jesus, hear and answer me. Deep in thy wounds, Lord, hide and shelter me. So shall I never, never part from thee. Guard and defend me from the foe malign. In that dread moments, make me only thine. Call me and bid me come to thee on high. When I may praise thee with thy saints for us. Soul of my Savior, sanctify my breast. Body of Christ, be thou my saving guest. Blood of my Savior, bathe me in thy tide. Wash me, ye waters, streaming from his side. Strength and protection, may his passion be. O blessed Jesus, hear and answer me. Deep in thy wounds, Lord, hide and shelter me. So shall I never, never part from thee. Guard and defend me from the saints for
I. Let us pray. Grant to pray, O Lord, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given us, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force on the church, and that its spiritual food may gain abundance, her abundance of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go and love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I wish you all a good feast day and hope that the Spirit will strengthen us. Thank you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. God's Spirit is in my heart. He has called me and set me apart. This is what I have to do, what I have to do. He sent me to give the good news to the poor. Set the